Hello, Cranksters. Today, we will guide you through setting up your miner from the very beginning. First, go over to the Crankk site, click on Downloads, and go to the Guides section. In this case, we're going to be onboarding a full gateway. Search the page for your miner's guide. I'm using a Nebra Rock Pi. Click, and it will open a full, easy-to-follow guide. Now, before you start anything, you need a few items to hand. Your miner, a screwdriver, the correct size to remove the miner screws, some kind of digital card reader, a digital mini SD card, and a large SD converter if your reader does not have the correct size slot. Now we're going to mount the Crankk software onto the card. First, download Balena Etcher via the link in your guide. This will be used to mount the software. Also, download the image that you're going to mount at this point. Once the downloads are complete, open Balena Etcher. Insert your card reader, containing the mini storage card, into your USB. Click on Flash from File. Choose the image that you downloaded. Select your target, which is your card reader drive, and then click the Flash button. Once it's completed, remove the card from the card reader, and you are ready for the next step. Undo the screws to access the miner insides. Insert the card, gold pins facing up, into the slot. This may be located differently depending on your miner model, so make sure you refer to the guide. Power up your miner and plug in your Ethernet connection, ready to connect. Next, you need to download PuTTY so we can access the miner and copy the information from the card onto the miner. This step is required for certain miners only, so refer to your guide to see if it's needed for your miner model. Enter the PuTTY website via the guide link and download the required version of PuTTY. Also, download Advanced IP Scanner via the guide link. This is used to check our connections and find the IP address of our miner. There are other methods to do this, so feel free to use another if you wish. When you run the software, it will show you the IP address associated with various devices on your network, including your miner. Right-click on the device name to copy the IP address. Run your PuTTY download. Type in the word root, followed by an @, followed by the copied IP address, and click open. Accept a pop-up and it will ask for a password. Type B, then an @, followed by TCH, then a 0, an N, then the number 3. Then type this command on the next line, TOEMMC, which means 2 embedded multimedia card. Follow that with a space, a forward slash, the word dev, another forward slash, followed by MMC, which stands for multimedia card, and then BLK1, which stands for block 1. Add another space, then 2 dashes, then the word net, another dash, and finally the word config. This command must be inputted correctly to proceed. The process will begin, and once completed, the software will be installed on your miner. To finish, type power off and PuTTY disconnects. You can now go back to your miner. Remove the mini card, put the screws back in, and restart the miner ready for the next step. Navigate to your favorite browser and type in your miner's IP address in the top bar, followed by semicolon 17080. Click sign in. No password is needed. You have now entered your Crankk local dashboard. The first thing you must do is set up your gateway. First, copy your gateway address into a text file as you will need it later. Then input the required information specific to your miner model and location. The packet forwarder needn't be touched unless you wish to not dual mine helium, in which case you can delete the last character string after the comma, but we recommend leaving it as is to make it simple. Click Save and you will see it is being configured. Now, we need the secret key for your wallet from your other Crankk dashboard. Navigate to the Wallets tab and click the three dots to choose the option to reveal the secret key. Copy the key and navigate back to the local dashboard wallet tab to paste the key in the required area. Your wallet information will now appear in place of the input box, so you know it is correct. Now you need to assign the gateway. Navigate to the dashboard once again and click the Wallets tab, where it says Assign Gateway. Click the button. Input your miner model and copy-paste your gateway ID from the saved text file. Once the miner has populated in your wallet area, you need to stake your Crankk token in the Proof of Trust section. Navigate to it to find out how much Crankk is needed, as this changes depending on Crankk price. Click on Confirm to stake your Crankk. If you don't have enough Crankk, you need to transfer it to your wallet. You should receive a message saying your request has been successful. The final thing to do is add a location for your miner. Navigate to the Gateways tab and click on the miner name. Look for location section in the miner. Zoom in and move the arrow around to try and find the location that you're in. Move the blue pin to your location and submit. The request is sent successfully. Congratulations, you have now set up your miner and you can start receiving your Crankk rewards.